place to keep my love. I don't need anything special, none of that stuff. I'm a snowy in your heart, and that's enough. Thank you for giving me a place to keep my love. Thank you for giving me a place to close my eyes. Surprise. Thank you for giving me a place to close my eyes.
Good morning. Welcome to St. Andrew's on this Thanksgiving weekend, which is also Christ the King weekend. It's good to have you all gathered in here this morning. Pastor Sarah is gone this weekend. She's at Rapid City with her family visiting for Thanksgiving. She'll be flying home tomorrow. Y'all have been complaining about the cold here. Yesterday it was 18 degrees there in Rapid City. It's warming up today to 29 degrees. And there's just a little bit of snow on the ground. So I don't think we'll be complaining about the cold here. I look forward to Pastor Sarah returning this week. A few announcements about today and this coming week at St. Andrew's. Following this service at 12:30, we'll have a blanket exercise in here. I'll be leading that with my daughter Isabel and Tom Hogel, one of my friends and colleagues that's here this morning as well. So we're looking forward to that time in here. If you have any questions about the blanket exercise, about attending, please see me following the service. It'd be great to have you be part of that blanket exercise in this space again at 12:30 this afternoon. This coming week, we have a Tuesday morning Bible study. It starts at 10 o'clock. That'll be in here or on Zoom. You can attend on Zoom. If you want to get the Zoom invite, you can email Mary Jo Precivelli, who leads that Bible study. And she will send you the Zoom link to be part of that study this week. And then we have all of our Wednesday intergenerational activities going on Wednesday night. And you can see the box in your pinch and the bulletin there with all the stuff that's going on, yoga, mini movers, confirmation. Dinner this week is enchiladas, beans, and rice. Looking forward to that meal. I guess we used to call it Fiesta Night, Can it still be fiesta night? It's different. So it's not a party because it's enchiladas. Okay, thank you, Chef Lisa. All that will be going on, and at 7 o'clock, we'll have our first midweek Advent service in the sanctuary with our holding even prayer that is a tradition here at St. Andrew's to do holden during Advent and also during Lent during midweek services. We'll look forward to that this Wednesday. And then next weekend, we have our crafters will have a craft pop-up sale following all of our services. So on Saturday night, that craft pop-up will be in the back of the room here. And then on the weekend, weather permitting, all the crafts will be outside in the courtyard. It's a great time to get those Christmas gifts together. I know Christmas is coming around the corner. So for family and friends, it's a great place to get those gifts and also support many of our ministries of St. Andrew's through that craft pop-up sale. Also during this month, you may have noticed all the boxes in the back that are overflowing in the back of this room. That's our collection drive for November. We had the canned food for the cupboard on 54th. Also, our Thanksgiving meal prep, that's all went out this week, of course, for the cupboard on 54th. And the clothing and blanket donations for Lutheran Border Concerns Ministry, and cereal and snack donations for Monty and Moe's. So thank you for bringing those donations to overflowing the last few weeks, and look forward to getting all those supplies to those organizations this week. And then on Thursday, December 7th, a week from this Thursday, we have our volunteer appreciation from 5 to 7 Thursday evening. It'll be light hors d'oeuvres and refreshments. That'll be on side B in here for that. We'll have Christmas music and a light fire, and the church staff puts that all together to thank all of you for your many ways that you serve here at St. Andrew's and are part of the ministry here. So look forward to that on December 7th. And then if you are a member, we encourage you to attend our congregational meeting on Sunday, December 10th. It's following this service, so we'll start about 11:15, 11:30 in the sanctuary for that congregational meeting. Start time depends on how long it takes us to get a quorum. So if you're a member, you are part of that quorum. If you'll attend, and we'll get that meeting started that much sooner to discuss our budget for 2024 and also update you on a few other issues here at St. Andrew's. And that is all our announcements. We do have, we have no prayer quilts. We do have altar flowers, and they will come over in just a few minutes. They're not there. They're in the sanctuary, but they'll be coming over here in just a few minutes. They're given by Ray and Phyllis Blanchard in celebration of their 54th wedding anniversary, so congratulations for them. And then also Robbie Atkinson Walkler was given flowers in memory of her mother, Doris, and her mother-in-law, Sarah. So we thank both of them for those flowers this morning. That'll be in here in just a couple minutes. And so we'll begin our worship with our peacemakers and their call to worship. Give me love, give me peace on earth.
Give me love, give me love. Give me peace on earth. Give me light, give me life. Keep me free from birth. Give me hope, help me cope with this heavy load. Trying to touch and reach you with heart and soul. Give me light, give me life. won't you give me love, give me love, give me peace on earth, give me light, give me life, keep me free from birth, give me hope, help me cope with this heavy load, trying to touch and reach you with heart and soul. Give me love, give me love, give me peace on earth, give me light, give me life, keep me free from birth now, give me hope, help me cope with this heavy load, trying to touch and reach you with heart and soul.
The front page of your bulletin for our confession of forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who is eager to forgive, who loves beyond our days. Dear friends, together let us acknowledge our failure to love this world as Jesus does. God of mercy and forgiveness, we confess that sin still has a hold on us. We have harmed your good creation. We have failed to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with you. Turn us in a new direction. Show us the path that leads to life. Be our refuge and strength on the journey. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and friend. Amen. Beloved of God, your sins are forgiven. You are made whole. God points the way to new life in Christ, who meets you on the road. Journey now in God's abiding love through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we sing our opening hymn, For the Fruit of All Creation. The words and music are in your bulletin, and the words will also be up on the screen.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of power and might, your Son shows us the way of service, and in him we inherit the riches of your grace. Give us the wisdom to know what is right, and the strength to serve the world you have made, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Our reading today comes from Ezekiel chapter 34. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out. As shepherds seek out their flocks when they are among their scattered sheep, so I will seek out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries, and will bring them into their own land. And I will feed them on the mountains of Israel, by the watercourses, and in all the inhabited parts of the land. I will feed them with good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel shall be their pasture. There they shall lie down in good grazing land, and they shall feed on rich pasture on the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I will make them lie down, says the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak, but the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them with justice. Therefore, thus says the Lord God to them, I myself will judge between the fat sheep and the lean sheep. Because you pushed with flank and shoulder and butted at all the weak animals with your horns until you scattered them far and wide, I will save my flock, and they shall no longer be ravaged, and I will judge between sheep and sheep. I will set up over them one shepherd, my servant David, and he shall feed them. He shall feed them and be their shepherd, and I, the Lord, will be their God, and my servant David shall be prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken. Word of God, word of life.
Thank you, Isaac. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 25th chapter. Jesus said to the disciples, when the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another as a shepherd separates sheep from the goats. And he'll put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at his left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, come, you are the blessed by my Father. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? When was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? When was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you? And the king will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me. Then he will say to those at his left hand, you that are accursed, depart from me into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not welcome me. Naked, and you did not give me clothing. Sick and in prison, and you did not visit me. Then they will also will answer, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not take care of you? Then he will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life. The gospel of the Lord. So as I mentioned in the welcome this weekend, we celebrate Christ the King. This is the last Sunday before Advent and the start of a new church year, a new liturgical year. It was Pope Paul VI in the 1960s who created the church calendar that we have today to emphasize the transformative dimension of what it means to call Jesus Christ the King. In Jesus' own lifetime and in the generations immediately following, to call Jesus Lord and King was to say that the Roman emperor was not the great authority over human lives. It was to honor what Jesus called in Matthew chapter 16, the countercultural and spiritual dimension of life. And our gospel lesson for today comes late in Matthew's gospel, just before Christ's passion. Some biblical scholars call it the judgment of the pagans, or refer to it as the last judgment. In our reading, Jesus is seen separating sheep and goats, described as a king on his throne, rewarding his subjects according to their adherence to his great ethical commandment of compassion to others. Passage comes in Matthew's last great teaching discourse, a long section about the end of the world and the completion of time. This is the last of many parables that we've had over the last several weeks about being ready for whatever is coming, whenever it gets here. A thief in the night, a slave and a master. Foolish bridesmaids who are unprepared. Slaves are given trust over small things while the master is away. There are apocalyptic stories about judgment and being prepared. And so Jesus has one more for us, one more to share. Except now, he's moved from paradoxical parables to apocalyptic language and imagery. This is the end. And here's how it's going to go down. We have Jesus, the judge, coming in full-blown apocalyptic glory. The big question I've been wrestling with this week is how we can understand and respond to this judgment parable. What I learned back in seminary is that apocalyptic writing as a literary genre is designed to bring hope to the oppressed and encouragement to the persecuted. Jesus' disciples and those first century followers of the way were going to know something about being persecuted and oppressed for their faith, for following Jesus' teachings. So these words would have given them peace and fed their faith. And as I've preached this text in the past many times, I would focus on the separation between sheep and goats. With the goats herded into eternal punishment and the sheep kind of trotting mentally into eternal life. It fits our human need to have clear division between who's in and who's out. Of course, with such division, we ourselves are tempted to determine who falls in the in and out scale. And in this case, no one wants to be a goat. Do you? We clearly see ourselves or imagine ourselves to be sheep who are supposed to be the good guys, right? Do any of you know the difference between a sheep and a goat? Are there any shepherds here this morning? Any ideas? Other than their hair? Other than their size? Well, if you visited Luther Glen Farm, you might know. They have both sheep and goats and a bunch of other farm animals. But what I learned for the first time from being at the farm is that a goat's tail will almost always be short and pointed upwards, and a sheep's tail will be pointed downwards. The other difference is that a sheep's upper lips are split right down the middle up here underneath its nose. So, if you have never experienced time at Luther Glen or had time working with sheep and goats, you likely would not know this about these animals. So I'm not surprised none of you raised your hands. So, my question again, are you a goat or a sheep? Are you doomed or saved? Are you a do-gooder or not? I would claim to be a goat. Because there's nothing I can do to earn my way into heaven or save myself from separation from our God. However, because of Jesus, God made flesh, I'm a goat and a sheep at the same time. We are, each one of us, an adopted child of God. So looking at the words of this parable from Matthew in sheep and goats, does this knowledge change anything for you? So if I can get past the sheep and goats, now we're past that. I believe what is clear is that Jesus is teaching us about far more about how we care for one another, and particularly those on the margins, on the fringes of our society. Even more important, it seems, that this caring is so much a part of the disciples' lifestyle that one is not even conscious of doing anything extraordinary. Disciples are even too busy looking for King Jesus to see him in the face in needs of others and their neighbors. Our King, Jesus, looks nothing like the world's idea of a king. And this parable highlights the fact that by depicting a king that fits our human notions of how things should be, and yet buried and woven through the story is the identity of the King of Kings. Yes, our King is found in and with the least of these. Our King walks with us. Our King blesses us, loves us, saves us, and invites us to be an active part of his reign in the already and the not yet. So people, get ready. It's the end of the church year, but it's the beginning of a new year and a new day. So come with open hands and open hearts and open mind to Christ's table, Christ the King's table, his altar, where goats and sheep are all welcome. Thanks be to God. Amen. As we come to our time of prayer, just a few prayer updates to share with you this morning. Continued prayers of healing and treatment for Betty Geldner. Last week, discovered a tumor on her kidney, was bleeding, and the bleeding has stopped, and she's doing better and healing up at home, but continued healing for Betty. So prayers of peace and comfort for Ida Tripp, who suffered a stroke a couple weeks ago, was hospitalized. She is home now. But they have started hospice care for Ida, so prayers of peace and comfort for Ida as well. And peace and comfort and freedom from pain for Rita. This is Mary Thomas's sister-in-law, and so we keep them all in our prayers this weekend. Let us turn our hearts to God, our breath and life, as we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. Holy God, from Christ we receive our call to feed, clothe, and welcome. Direct your church to respond to this call with faithfulness and generous love. We pray for the work of the ELCA World Hunger, for Lutheran Border Concerns, and all their partnerships with international feeding ministries. Lord, in your mercy, in Christ, we are made the people of his pasture. Inspire this congregation's outreach and social ministries. Especially, we pray for Monty and Mose, the Cupboard on 54th and 3rd Avenue Charitable Organization. We pray for all people who serve and attend to the needs of others. Lord, in your mercy, in Christ, the rock of our salvation, we are brought into union with all of creation, with mountains, seas, dry lands and animals of the field. We seek your guidance and protection. Lord, in your mercy, in Christ we know merciful judgment. Guide rulers of every nation in ways of humble leadership and wise decision making. Allow aid to come to all who are underserved and care for any who are neglected. We continue to pray for peace in Ukraine and Israel and Gaza, to bring your peace between nations and peoples. Lord, in your mercy, in Christ, we feel the depth of your love and care towards us. Nourish all who hunger. Connect any who are isolated and surround all who experience rejection or abuse. We pray for those who suffer in any way. And pray now silently for those we know. We offer our spoken prayers and those held in our hearts, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. We share that peace with one another. Lord's peace, Isaac. I will after this sermon. I'll grab it. Lord's peace, Bob. As we come to our time of offering now, I just want to remind you to float those blue slips that you're stuffed in your bulletin, right next to any prayer updates, and you want the office staff to know about, or the pastors on those blue slips. There's also maybe a couple boxes on there that are pertinent to you, so please look over those, all those as well. You can find that blue slip in your chat as well if you're worshiping with us online. Also on that blue slip is a QR code, which you can use your device to give electronically, find our giving page that way. It's also in the offering, in the bulletin itself, at the offering explanation, there's a little blue code there as well that you can scan and give. You can also just put your offering in the offering plate this morning. And again, we thank our peacemakers for their continued work and their gift to sharing their music with us this morning.
Takes a
Let us pray. God of all goodness, generations have turned to you, gathered around your table, and shared your abundant blessings. As we gather these gifts, we thank you for your rich blessings. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. All right, I'd like to invite the children forward now for the children's sermon. You guys can come on up. So where have you guys been in here the whole time?
No.
No? Where were you?
At Sunday school.
What happened in Sunday school today?
Nothing.
We basically just played.
You played up there?
Yeah, and we ate snack.
You had snack? Good. Okay, and no stories? You didn't have any stories today?
No.
Yeah,
no
stories. We didn't know what stories we were supposed to do.
Ah, okay.
And Miss Alice wasn't there.
And Miss Alice wasn't there this morning. All right. Very good. So your parents in here and all of us heard a story about some animals. About the sheep and the goats. That's right. Were you in here? You were listening. Good. So I brought some animals. Can you guys help me identify them? I think these are all, that's a horse, right? That's a cow. What's this one then? It's
cow.
A cow.
Calf.
Calf. Okay.
Cow.
Anybody want to guess what kind of cow this might be? It has a special name. Holstein, I think.
Cow.
Just a cow. We don't have any jerseys in here. Another cow.
Why do you keep pulling out cows?
I'm going to collect all the cows over there. And then what about this dude?
Pig.
An
odd-looking pig.
A very odd-looking pig is right. He's kind of scary looking. This one looks a little better, right?
Yeah, pig. Very.
Ooh, you forgot a cow.
Oh, did I forget one?
Cow.
That's a little cow.
Cow.
Let's see. Oh, another pig.
That one's
this one already looks like it's been smoked.
This one's bacon.
Yep, that one's bacon. I got another pig in here. Oh, look, we forgot one. That's a cow. It might be a Jersey. Another smoked up pork pig. Yep. Oh, look, another cow. That's a bull. Okay, it might be a bull. I just looked underneath. There's a pig. Another bull. Very good. Oh, look, another one. These cows just keep coming. They're like propagating in this box. Look, another one.
They're taking over the animal planet.
They are.
Horse.
Oh, and a horse. Good job.
The horses are the least.
Maybe a pony. Okay, we're getting down to the good stuff. What's this?
Chicken! Rooster!
Did any of you eat chicken this week?
No.
No, I do not like chicken.
What did you eat instead? What did you have? What poultry did you have this week? Turkey. You didn't have turkey? All right. Okay, now we're getting to what we talked about tonight, or this morning in my sermon. How do you know that's a goat?
You know because the tail's on the bottom, the tail is going downward.
Mm-hmm.
And basically because
there's two goats.
The tail is going downward and the sheep and it doesn't have a cut on the leg.
Excuse me?
That's right. Yes.
I remember that we learned that funky song. It was about like how like the I think it was the like the goat. You don't want to be a goat.
Oh, that's right. I think Pastor Sarah taught you a song. She's pretty good at teaching songs. I am not. So that's why I have to have props because I can't lead songs. So what are these? Very
this
good.
Looks more like a wolf.
That looks like a wolf.
A wolf. Looks like an
what's a wolf?
A wolf.
Like a small alpaca.
And more sheep.
Maybe.
And more sheep. And more sheep.
Hey, is there a llama?
There's no llamas here. Okay.
What?
So I've separated all these farm animals now. Can you guys see the difference between them?
Yes.
All right. But what we talked about today was sheep and goats. Is there a huge difference between these sheep and goats?
Yes.
Like the same as there is between a cow and a goat? You remembered all that. That's right. The tail, that's right, and the little slit in the middle of its lip. Very good. So Jesus tells a story about how he's going to judge people like sheep and goats. And the sheep have a thing about kind of following a little bit more, and they have shepherds that take care of them and keep them safe. Goats are more kind of wild and some might even say stubborn. Yeah, they have their own ideas about things. Yep, and they'll kind of do things on their own. They're also a bit hardier, I think, too, out in the wild. They have horns, very good. Yep, and some sheep have horns, too. Yep. So for us, does it matter if... So one of the things that Jesus talks about, one of the things that we talked about in here is that, what do you have here?
And we have the rest of the animal kingdom.
Yes, you do. Very good. What is this one?
A yak.
Well, man, we missed that one. Now we got it. We got a yak in here. Very good. So what's one thing that all these animals have in common, that we have in common with these animals?
We're all animals.
We're all animals. And guess what else? God loves each and every one of us. That's right. All of us. God loves us. Yep. Very good. And we're going to talk about his love and how he shares that love up here at communion now, okay? I kind of did. So can you guys put all these animals back in their box? Except for the yak. I think the yak's not going to fit. Good job. That was fun. All right. I don't think the yak's going to fit. Very good. All right. Now you're going to look up here as we celebrate this meal of love that we call communion, and you're going to say the words with me, right? The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. As we remember in the night in which betrayed the Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all who drink, saying, this cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. And now we're going to bow our heads, fold our hands, and close our eyes and pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Give us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And you guys can go back to your seats now. And as they're going back, I want to welcome you all forward for communion this morning. You do not remember this church or Lutheran, you see the body and blood of Christ. All are welcome to come forward, eat. You're going to receive, like to invite our communion assistants forward, our acolyte forward at this time, and our ushers. And as they're coming up, I'll share with you how we're going to commune. You're going to come forward, forming a line down the center aisle. You'll come up, make a circle on this altar and stage. You'll receive a piece of bread, individual cup of wine or juice. Please eat and drink these elements as you receive them. Then you can put the empty cup in the tray for empties. Once everybody's communed in the circle, we're going to join hands, and there'll be a blessing. Find that blessing. Go back to your seat using the side aisles so the line continue formed on the center aisle. A couple things you need to know. We do like to give communion by first name, so if you're not wearing a name tag, I may be asking for your name. Also, if you prefer not to have communion, you can keep your hands folded. That'll let me know you want a blessing instead of communion. Just keep your hands folded. And finally, we do have gluten-free crackers up here as well. So if you're gluten intolerant, that's up here as well. That is everything you need to know. The table is prepared, and all are welcome.
The sun will keep on rising, and that old
know that you're gonna be okay. Not a care in this old world can take that truth away. You're gonna be okay. You're gonna be alright.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, in this simple meal, you have set a banquet. Sustain us on the journey. Strengthen us to care for the least of your beloved children. And give us glad and generous hearts as we meet you on the way. Amen. And receive this benediction. Beloved children of God, you have been equipped with the knowledge of God and the Word of God. Created to be disciples, you are sent into the world as a blessing to love your neighbors. Go now and share your blessedness with the world. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. And we sing our closing hymn, I Love to Tell the Story. Go in peace. Be who God created you to be.
Thanks be to God.